are so glad you are here. Glad that you took the time out of your day. We're very excited about our play. We got to do it one time last night. It was just really fun and great, and I know some of you were here then. And so it was so good you came back. Thank you. So the play is called The Rock Slinger and His Greatest Hit. Written by two wonderful guys, Tom Long and Alan Pote, and very clever men. And so a couple of business things. Be sure right now to silence your cell phones and pagers, or turn them off completely if that's possible. And then we do not allow flash photography, and that's for the safety of the performers, because the flash can cause issues as they're looking out into the audience. So if you would refrain from flash photography, that would be great. You are welcome to take non-flash photography.
Thank you. Status report.
The giant stopped, sir. He is taking up his normal position.
Okay, all clear.
I don't get it. Why is everybody hiding? Guys, I want you to meet my little runt-in brother. A shepherd and part-time singer for the king. What are you doing down here, David?
Dad sent me with some food for you.
Look, why don't you go back and do a ditty for King Saul? This is a spot for real soldiers.
Yeah. I just don't get why everybody's so scared.
It's an enemy's secret weapon, Goliath of Gath.
He comes out every day and shouts insults at us.
Yeah, and then he challenges us to fight him one-on-one.
Well, why don't you?
Are you kidding? Nobody can fight him.
Yeah, you don't know anything about military stuff.
Where have you been?
Watching sheep.
Well, the man's a monster.
He looks like he fell out of an ugly tree.
Yeah, and hit every branch on the way down.
You cannot fight your way on a wet parchment bag.
When I worked my I will upon you, it will look as if you slept on a bed of nails. Face down.
In the name of the gods of the Philistines, Dagon, Ashtaroth, and Beelzebub, I hereby curse you.
This is terrible. They're defying the army of God. Somebody's ought to answer.
Yeah, but who's gonna do it?
Listen, if somebody killed Goliath, would King Saul reward them?
He's right. The king would probably give you land and riches.
Ooh. Even better, I bet your family would never have to pay taxes again.
Ooh. And then the king might even give you his daughter's hand in marriage.
Wait a minute. Which daughter?
The youngest one, Michael.
Princess Michael? I know her. She's a friend of mine.
Is that right?
No, really. I see her when I sing at the palace.
You little know-it-all. You can't fool me.
What do you mean?
I know what you're really doing. You just want to see a battle.
What did I say? All I said was somebody ought to teach this Goliath a lesson. Am I right?
Yeah.
We've had enough of that Philistine trash talk.
Yeah.
It's an outrage.
Yeah. We're not going to take it anymore.
Yeah.
So who's going to stand up and do it?
I'm kind of busy.
It's not my job.
I have a previous commitment.
What kind of excuses are those?
What? Who are my better ones?
Why did you say so?
I'm allergic to Philistines.
My dog is a battle plan.
I fought at the office.
Sorry, I'm a little short today.
I just washed my sling and I can't do a thing with it.
I'm Raven Challenge.
I'm sudden death intolerant.
Come on, there's gotta be somebody.
Who will fight the giant? Yes! Who will fight the giant? Come on! Who will fight the giant? Let's hear it. Not me, not me, not me, not me. Who will fight the giant?
Thanks.
Who will fight the giant?
Him? You've got to be kidding me.
No, really. Tell the king he can send me.
Hello?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Goliath.
Goliath who?
Goliath's down in the field
and watch your sheep.
He's right, kid. Nobody's gonna tell the king a harebrained idea like that.
Why not? Look at you. Goliath's 9 feet tall. You're small enough to pose for trophies.
You're so little, you gotta use ladder to lace up your sandals.
You're so short, you gotta cuff your underwear.
Hey, leave him alone. At least he has the courage to speak up. Who are you?
I'm a friend.
Ooh, I'm afraid.
Don't you know that's the king's daughter?
Princess Micah? Like I said, I'm afraid I have a major acquaintance. Oh, Shalom, beautiful princess, fairest of all women. Your nose like a cedar of Lebanon. Your lips like a pomegranate could open. Your neck like
a... Please, please, try not to grovel on my toenails.
So sorry, Your Highness. I had no idea.
Somehow I'm not surprised.
Michael, what are you doing?
I'm sticking up for you. So listen up, all you great big heroes. I know you think David's a joke, but you don't know him like I do. When my father's having one of his temper tantrums, David's the only one who can calm down. Everybody else runs off. But David, David stays and plays music.
Please, Michael, you don't have to defend me.
I want to. That's what friends are for. So next time you're all running scared, look around and see he's still standing tall. You might be surprised. Are you okay?
I don't know. That was kind of embarrassing.
Hey, if your friends can't say good things about you, who can?
I guess so.
Besides, you do the same to me.
Well...
Come on, you know you would.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
So maybe next time you'll be there for me. This is just my turn.
Thanks.
Don't mention it.
So you don't think I'm crazy?
You're standing up for God, right?
Yeah.
Well then, crazy or not, I'm right here with you.
And in the Lord will stand.
fight Goliath.
Are you sure?
I am now. I tell myself, but I don't think he'd listen.
Don't worry, I'll do it.
Make way once again for the approach of the shield bearer of Goliath.
The mighty Goliath grows even more weary of dealing with cowardly vermin who will not fight.
You are beneath even his written insults.
He once again sends us his lowly servants to insult you in his place,
using our own words as we see fit.
And so we say unto you. Call yourself soldiers? You couldn't even find your own swords with a map.
Looks like they're a few plagues short of an exodus.
If they were any more stupid, you'd have to water them twice a week.
So Rachel, powerful god, taking a nap?
Oh, didn't you know? They worship a god you can't see or touch.
Yeah, they call him Yahweh.
I think they have to call him Noah.
Hey, what do Israelites say when they call their God for help?
No way, no way, no way.
This is even worse. Now they're making fun of God. We've got to do something.
giant. What if he kills you? If God saved me from lions and bears, I know he can save me from a Philistine. What do you say, Michael? Do you believe this boy?
I'm afraid for him, Father, but I know God's with him.
All right, David, I'll let you go. Under one condition. What? You have to wear my armor to protect yourself. Just because God's on your side doesn't mean you can use a little extra insurance. Commander!
Yes, sir?
Get this shepherd ready for battle.
Bring out the king's armor.
And if this doesn't work, I'm going to be so mad, I'll chew on a spearhead and spit needles.
Breastplate. Shin guard. Shoulder piece. Thigh brace. Foot mantle. Armband. Knee blade. Elbow cap. Wrist cover. Neck sheath. Face lock. Helmet. Shield. Spear. Dagger. Sword.
Kid, you got that.
Thanks, brother.
take one from a shepherd.
Thanks for keeping watch, David.
One from my king.
Stand up. You have a job to do.
Yes, Your Highness.
Are you sure you don't want that armor?
No, just one more stone. This one I choose in the name of Yahweh, who is our friend, our family, our shepherd, and our king.
Thank you.
So, you want to fight me, little boy?
I come so the whole world will know there's a God in Israel.
There's a God, all right. His name is Beelzebub, God of the Philistines. And by Beelzebub, I'll hack you to pieces and feed you to the birds.
You defy my God, but today the Lord will deliver you into my hand.
What? With that stick? You think I'm a dog? You gonna play fetch with me?
You carry spear, but I come in the name of Lord of Hosts.
Curse you, little maggot. You're jackalving.
Not this day. This day, the battle is the Lord's.
They stand and face each other. They circle to the right. It looks as though Goliath is sure to win the fight. And Gavin's moving left. It is like an awful dance. He's waltzing with the giant. He hasn't got a chance.
Shield bearer!
in the front row. Please stand up. And then the people in the AV booth. To have wonderful volunteers who come and help us. So it is time for the kids to go and get their costumes off in just a minute. We have a couple of announcements. We do have cookies, but if you could kind of hold on a little bit for those, hold off. We would really appreciate help with the chairs. We need to put the chairs into, many of them put away to get into configuration for our evening service. And so since we have many of you here, if you can help do that, that would be great. There are probably some spearhead people who can tell you exactly what to do. So again, we so appreciate you coming. We so appreciate you bringing your kids. They are just delightful. We have so much fun working with them and singing with them and playing with them. They are a real blessing for us. Thanks so much for coming.